What I have here in front of me is a 3.5-foot electric eel, capable of producing an electric shock up to 860 volts, enough to take down a horse, let alone me. To put that in perspective, that's about 8 times the voltage that's in your household outlet. And I never stuck my finger in the outlet as a kid. I listened to my mom. But right now, I'm about to stick my hand in this tank to experience the shock of an electric eel. Can't tell. I am definitely nervous. This is easily the craziest thing I've ever done on the Brave Wilderness channel. Whew. Oh my gosh, I cannot believe how nervous I am right now. Ah, all right, here we go. Gonna go for a shock. Here we go. 1, 2, 3.
Now, before you witness the results of my first electrocution, it's important to note that this electric eel is an educational ambassador for its species and was not harmed by shocking. Please do not attempt to recreate what you're about to see. This experiment was filmed under the supervision of professionals.
Ah! Whoa! Wow! Holy smokes! Ooh, yeah, that you don't expect. You definitely do not expect that from a fish. Wow, holy mackerel. You see an animal like this, and yeah, it looks strange, but you never in your life expect a fish to be able to shock you like that. Whoa, as soon as I made contact with the eel, it was like instant, oh my gosh. Whew. The good news is, my first shock with the electric eel is over. The bad news is, that's not my last shock of the day. This is just the beginning. Underneath that tarp, we have an absolutely monstrous electric eel, one that will dwarf the size of this one. And in case you're wondering, yes, size does matter when it comes to shocks in electric eels. But before we get to the ultimate shock, we need to understand a little bit more about what's going on inside the body of this animal that allows it to produce this tremendous amount of energy. In order to do that, I've invited my good friend, Diana Physics Girl, here today to put me through a few more shock experiments so we can learn a little bit more about what's going on in the electric eel. All right, let's go meet up with Diana. Ah! Oh! Oh my gosh. Oh boy, Diana. I'm usually so excited to see you. Why am I nervous right now?
I mean, usually I haven't brought one of these to our reunions.
Oh my gosh, yeah. What is this, speaking of?
Yo. Well, you wanted me to teach you about how shocking works, and so that's what we're gonna do with this thing here. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm just gonna turn this on. You're going to then touch it quickly, but as I turn it on, as it gets warmed up, you're gonna feel like a little tingling.
All right, hold up.
Yeah.
I have to touch this?
You're gonna have to touch it. Yeah. Okay, ready?
Okay, go for it. Wait. Why do you look nervous?
Because I hate this thing.
Okay.
I've experienced it.
All right.
Yeah. Finger straight out toward that big metal sphere.
Ah!
Try my arm?
Yeah.
Ooh,
whoa.
That's a big one.
Whoa! See my hair standing up? I think I can smell my hair burning, actually. Whoa.
How does that feel?
Ah, that's about as much as I can take. Now, you've got my attention. How does this relate to electric eels?
So what we're doing with this thing, this is called a Van de Graaff generator, and it's the perfect thing for understanding charge, because what happens here is a bunch of charges build up on this sphere, and then as soon as you bring your hand near it, they discharge, they actually travel through the air to your finger.
So that's like the little lightning bolt that I'm seeing. Got it. So okay, I think I understand now. So basically, this Van de Graaff globe represents an electrocyte in the eels.
Yeah, exactly. In the eel, they build up charge and then it discharges all at once, just like the spark from the Van de Graaff generator.
Got it. So it's like a chain reaction. So very much like a battery. And here's a cool fact. The first battery is actually invented by a gentleman named Volta, and he actually designed his first battery off of the inner workings of the electric eel. So without this animal, there would be no Duracell, and there certainly would not be a Tesla, which is pretty cool. Okay, so the eel, we couldn't measure the first shock, but we know they can be up to like 860 volts.
Mm-hmm.
How many volts was this?
This is about 350,000.
A what?
350,000 volts.
How am I standing here? Are you trying to kill me?
That's the difference between voltage and current.
Got
so
it.
You need to know about both. So we've got one more experiment to learn about current.
Okay, so mm-hmm. there's more shocks to come.
There's a lot more. Next experiment I've got, so this is a TENS unit. A lot of people are probably more familiar with this. So this is gonna give you some little pulses of electricity through your arm.
All right.
It is going through your skin and some of the tissues just below your skin. And now I'm gonna turn it on and then I'm gonna go ahead and just bump it up little by little.
Okay.
You feel anything?
Nothing. Oh yeah, something's happening.
Yeah, you felt that?
Yeah, a little something.
What does it feel like?
It feels tingly. Yeah, I think I could take some.
How about?
Oh! I didn't do that.
Can we go up a little higher? We're at number 2, by the way.
How high does it go?
Out of 8. How are you feeling?
I think I can go to a 4. Let's try a 4.
Okay, we're gonna go up to a 3.
I'm not doing that, I swear.
I feel a little bad, but not that bad. We probably only got up to about 25 volts there.
So really?
It's really, really low in comparison.
Oh, I would have guessed it was like a million volts.
Nope.
Okay.
Nope. But the thing is that there's more energy flowing, more mm-hmm. charges flowing through here. Should we go higher than a 4? How do you feel about that?
Let it rip.
Okay. Ready?
Yep.
Okay, here we go. Up to as high as I can.
Ah! Okay. Tap out. Okay.
That was a 6.
That was a six.
But yeah, the biggest difference is that there's more current flowing.
Yeah.
And that's what's gonna get you, because you've got more energy. Plus, it's not as fast. Like the Eel, the Van de Graaff generator, like bam, you're done. This is continual.
Okay.
So yeah.
Okay.
Current's what's gonna do you in.
I still need this hand for another Eel shock. So we needed to find a way for everyone at home to see the mm-hmm. shock from the Eel, because mm-hmm. like obviously right here, you could see that I was feeling the current. You could see the lightning bolt from the Van de Graaff, but mm-hmm. you can't really see anything happening with the Eel shock. How mm-hmm. can we maybe visualize it?
Yeah, so we've got one more thing set up to be able to see there's actually electricity running through the water.
As it turns out, the electric eel isn't actually an eel at all. It is a species of knifefish that are more closely related to carp and catfish. But they are definitely electric. Their tail contains 3 electric organs that are each packed with thousands of cells called electrocytes. These cells act like a series of batteries, one stacked on top of another, and by moving electrons across their surface, they can produce shocks on demand. And I mean big shocks, and lots of them. So for this next experiment, we're going to harness all of that energy and turn it into visual fireworks that you can see.
Whoa, right, what is this?
Come on in here. Okay, so this is a Tesla coil.
Okay.
Yeah, so you remember the spark from the Van de Graaff generator?
I sure do.
Much bigger on this one, and we are not gonna touch this one because the sparks are gonna be like 6 inches. This one's dangerous.
Really?
Okay. Yeah, yeah. I didn't bring this one. This was made, actually rigged up by my friends from Arc Attack.
Okay.
And this whole system was made by them. There's some probes in the water in the tank. We will sense the electric shock from the eel through the water, and then it's directly connected to the Tesla coil. So we'll be able to see through the spark every single time the eel is shocking the water, or
Perfect.
You.
Or me.
Or we'll see it, we'll hear it. It's gonna be really cool.
Well, this is perfect. Thank you for building this. Thank you to Arc Attack for putting this together. I think all that's left to do now is to reveal the eel and fire this up. It's time for the grand finale, folks. You ready?
I'm ready.
Here we go.
So nervous.
Are you ready, Diana?
I'm ready.
On 3. 1, 2, 3. Oh, it's the whole tank.
Oh my gosh.
That eel is over 1 meter in length, over 1.5 feet longer than the eel this morning. And like I told you, size does matter when it comes to electric eels and their shock. Basically, the bigger the battery, the bigger the charge. Should we turn on the Tesla coil?
Yeah, let's hear it.
Oh! What?
That is all the eel.
That makes it so much worse.
Every single shock, that's all the eel. Oh, Mark.
I was so nervous earlier. This is making it way, way worse. Okay.
That is so cool, but I do not envy you.
Here we go.
You may be wondering why this electric eel is producing electricity unprovoked. Well, there's a reason they have 3 electric organs. The Sachs organ pulses with a lower voltage shock, which is used like radar for electrocommunication and navigation throughout its environment. This is important since they live in the murky waters of South America and have extremely poor eyesight. Then there's the mane and hunter's organs. These are the ones that produce those infamous high-voltage shocks, which are used to stun their prey so they can be swallowed alive.
All right, here we go. Okay. All right. On three, here we go. I'm Mark Vins, and this is getting shocked by a really big electric eel. One, two, three. Nope. Got nervous, sorry.
This really sets the scene for you, Mark.
Sure does. Thanks, Diana. I love science. All right. That's the eel doing all this.
That's all the eel.
Okay, let me see if I can feel it. Oh!
You felt that?
Yeah.
That's cool.
I can tell you this, the eel this morning was not doing this.
Yeah, yeah.
This eel is feisty. This shock is gonna be bad. All right, here we go. This shock is gonna be really bad. All right, here comes the big shock. I'm Mark Vins, and this is getting shocked by a really big electric eel. Here goes nothing. One, two, ooh, I can feel it in the water. Three. Yeah! Oh my gosh!
You okay, Mark?
Yeah. Hold on, give me a second. That really felt bad.
Turn these lights on real quick.
Oh. Yeah. That was so much worse. That was a lot worse than this morning. Holy smokes. Did you see the shock? I heard it.
Yeah.
Oh man, like, sorry, I'm trying to compose myself. Let me try to describe to you guys what I just went through. Obviously, I got shocked really bad, like, holy cow, you could hear the Tesla coil. I think it might have exploded, I don't know. Before I could feel it, my legs were locked, I could, my abdomen locked up.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I'm trying to tell everybody what it was like.
Yeah.
Holy cow. Did we break the Tesla coil?
I'm not sure.
I think it exploded.
That sound is like a horror movie. Like, it was like a bzzz.
I could still feel it.
Yeah.
Like up and down.
Yeah, does it burn? Like, what is it?
It's just like, I think it's just my nerves are just like freaking out.
Fully fired on that side of your body.
Yeah. It's definitely up here.
Only on the one side?
Yeah, like this arm's fine, this arm, and then up through here.
Oh my god.
Oh, dude, your ear's red.
Is it?
It's bright red.
Holy. Look at that.
Yeah.
Bright red.
Is it? It feels hot. That was the craziest thing I've ever done.
Yeah.
Live to tell about it. Shocked by an electric eel. Diana, thank you so much.
Oh my God.
If you haven't checked out Physics Girl on YouTube, Diana does some pretty darn cool experiments. I highly recommend you subscribe to her channel. Big thanks to Architect. I hope I didn't break your Tesla coil. And thank you for watching this video. This is absolutely the craziest thing I've ever done, but hopefully you learned a lot today about electric eels and how crazy of an animal they truly are. I'm Mark Vins. Be brave. Stay wild. We'll see you on the next experiment.
Oh God.
All right, let's go.